All right, my name's Sean Michael Walker with Premier Group Insurance, and I wanted to come to you this morning with a funny little story, nothing else, real quick little message. It's just a real funny little story about what underwriting used to look like versus what underwriting looks like today, and what we can learn from that just real quickly. So I used to work for a carrier a long time ago that actually insured Elvis Presley. And it's fun. It was fun back then to look through the underwriting file and see the notes that were made about Elvis Presley as he started before he was actually famous, and just about the Presley family, and see how that Elvis Presley risk continued to grow and cause problems for the insurance company. And so I want to talk about that just real quickly. In, I think it was June 5th, 1956, Elvis Presley had never been recorded from the waist down. He had always been recorded on national television from the waist up. And on June 5th, 1956, it was the very first time Elvis Presley was recorded on national television, gyrating and dancing and all that kind of stuff. And the reason why I use the word gyrating is because I think it was in the New York Times the very next day on June 6th, 1956, that there was a famous article that said something along the lines of, there is no place in music for gyration, which is hilarious because we obviously see how the music industry has changed as well, because clearly gyrating is a very normal thing within the music industry. But it was amazing because Elvis Presley gyrating on national television was just mind-blowing. The whole nation was going absolutely nuts 12 hours after his performance, and it was crazy. Oddly enough, in his underwriting file, it actually mentions gyrating. So it talks about, I think it's the underwriter, or I don't know, maybe it's the actual insurance agent. You know, there's communication back and forth between the underwriter and the agent. But ultimately it says, we should have known better than to insure this this auto policy with this Elvis Presley. I mean, the reality is last night he was seen on national television gyrating in front of a nation full of youngsters, and I can't believe that we've actually chosen to insure this individual. And it's just so funny and interesting to look at what underwriting used to be, right? Underwriting used to be the guy dances inappropriately and therefore he's not insurable, or we don't think he's as good of an insurable risk as, you know, dot, dot, dot. Which is absolutely unheard of. It's absolutely insane. You're hearing this on the video, probably jaw dropped, going, I can't believe that an insurance company was talking about somebody's dance moves and making insurance related or underwriting related decisions about a risk, right? Absolutely absurd. Now, if we were to fast forward to 2020 today, we know that 98% of the companies out there today are working on predictive modeling. They're working on creating algorithms and predictive underwriting and predictive modeling so that nobody has to touch the policy, so that there's this pass-through rate, so that nobody, no person has to sit there and say, well, wait a second, what color is the car? Is it a pink Cadillac? Because if it's a pink Cadillac and it's a boy driving it, well, there's something suspicious here, right? Of course not. And how does that young man dance when he goes to prom? Does he dance appropriately or does he dance inappropriately? It doesn't matter. And when it comes to, is that boy going to get into an accident or not, it really doesn't matter. The reality is the underwriting game has changed so dramatically, laughably dramatically, over the course of the last 70 years that it's kind of fun to take a quick look back and go, what was it back then and what is it today? Today, 98% of the companies are running towards predictive modeling. 98% of the companies are trying to automate this process so that they can get the expense ratios down. Why are they doing that? Because there are juggernaut insurance companies proving that you can actually do it, that you can lower the loss ratio, lower the expense ratio, and become a winner all day long, every day. No longer, thankfully, no longer do they worry about what our dance moves are, and now they're more concerned about what our actual driving behaviors are. With that, I'll say my name's Sean Michael Walker with Premier Group Insurance, and I hope you have a wonderful day. Thanks, bye-bye.